Style is more than skin deep. It is the cutting edge of creation itself. Jinky 8, with the shadow of mediocrity and the city of exquisiteness, and it's the path of style. My wisdom story. When I was a little girl, I sang everywhere I went and all of the time. I was so full of music, it just burst out of me. My mother raised me on her own. She was deaf, so she couldn't hear me sing, although she could see the surprised and offended looks on people's faces when we went out together. She herself had worked so hard to fit in that she felt embarrassed by my singing and worried for me. So she shushed me when we went out and put me in a school where singing was forbidden. I instinctively understood she was trying to protect me, and I loved her, so I learned to swallow my voice and blend in. I became just like everyone else, a pleasant student, an unthreatening classmate, obedient daughter and a model of mediocrity. I followed all the rules. My teachers liked me. My mother was proud. And as a young woman, I had everything I was taught to want. A respectable and substantial place in the world, manicured nails, the latest fashion, a respectable job. But it was all artificial. When yet another marriage fell apart, I couldn't deny the truth anymore. I wasn't happy. I felt trapped, almost wooden. On the surface, my life seemed shiny, but it was flat. Nothing truly glowed. Until I found myself walking past a park that was filled with all kinds of people, the kind I normally avoid like the plague. They were drumming and dancing in a circle with such abandon that they didn't seem to care if anyone was watching. Someone grabbed me by the hand and I found myself leaping into the center of the circle. And the next thing I knew, my eyes closed, body swayed, and my own voice started ringing out. I felt alive again. I was too happy and terrified to hear the applause. That was long ago. It took me many years to integrate the courage I experienced that day, to work through my fears of both succeeding and failing. Now, of course, I sing everywhere and all the time, whenever my rebel soul moves me to, and I think just as freely as I sing. My gift to you. I have a hunch there is a voice in you longing to be heard. I am here to encourage you to stop worrying about blending in. Dare to be an original. Don't just follow the trends. Be a rebel with a cause. Embrace your own style and let it come from deep inside. When I see you doing something that others may think is crazy or too much, I know that you are as sane could be. Maybe there are people who won't stick around. I understand how painful that can be. I can also promise you there will be others who will be so inspired by your style that they'll catch the authenticity bug. So please, get comfortable with being a fringe dweller. Trust that the world will catch up with you in its own good time. No matter what your passion is, give it some air, set it free, and expect nothing less than exquisiteness. And here are some questions you can ask yourself to deepen your contemplation. In what ways did you learn to blend in, to be like everyone else? Where are you still blending in, but secretly wanting to leap out? What would you do if you weren't afraid of what others would think of you? Is there a risk you've been longing to take in service of a passion, but you've been afraid of failure or success? What is your fear? Where can you receive support and encouragement? How can you hoax out of your individual creative style? Complete the sentence. When I am in my exquisiteness, I am. Repeat as many times as you like and write what emerges in your journal. That's it. Much love and happy contemplating.